The slow motion muscle up is maybe even more spectacular than the regular one. For most people, it seems impossible. But in this video, I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know so you'll be able to master it. What's up guys, it's Adam from gymnasticsmethod.com. If you don't want to miss my videos about bodyweight training and lifestyle, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell. And if you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method workout programs, tutorials like planche, handstand or muscle up, nutrition guide, daily workouts and much more, click the link below and join now on gymnasticsmethod.com. So, the slow motion muscle up. If you are not familiar with it, the slow motion muscle up is a kind of muscle up where you do the same movement from passive hang with absolutely no momentum, but slow and controlled movements. You can do slow-mo muscle up on the rings and bar as well. The execution on the rings is much easier since you can move the rings and have more control. Furthermore, it doesn't require the explosive pull-up anyway, like in the bar muscle up. So if you get the technique of the regular rings muscle up, you'll be able to do the slow-mo muscle up. You just need to do all the movements slower. No big deal. If you're interested in that, I made a video about the 5 checkpoints of the perfect rings muscle up, so check that out if you haven't already. You can spot the difference much more easily between the regular and slow-mo bar muscle up. In the regular bar muscle up, the most important things are the little motion of the body during the exercise and the explosive pulling, which helps you to get over the bar. It's enough to grab the bar with regular overhand grip, and thanks to the explosive pulling, you'll basically fly through weightless in the transition so you can turn your wrists easily. I've already talked about the prerequisites and technique of the regular bar muscle up in my previous videos that you can find on the channel. With these in mind, let's talk about the slow motion muscle up on the bar because it's a whole different story. Now you know how it looks like, what's the difference between that and the regular execution, so let's see what you need to do to be able to jump into it. First of all, I'd like to clarify that the slow motion muscle up on the bar is quite an intermediate exercise, so before you get into it, you need to be done already with a general joint preparation program, a basic strength program, and at least a muscle up on the rings. I've already talked about these on the channel, and if you want to do this in a complete system, click the link in the description. So after these basics, specifically for the slow motion bar muscle up, you need the following: wrist mobility and strength, elbow preparation and tricep strength, full range of motion pull-ups and straight bar dips, and the technique. As I've already mentioned, I've talked about these topics earlier, so let's repeat briefly what you need to do specifically. Same as in the rings muscle up, so here you'll need the false grip to be able to get over the bar. To be able to do the false grip, you need good wrist flexion that you can get with the back of the hand mobilizations. Besides the mobility, you'll need forearm flexor strength to be able to hold the false grip. You can improve that on a basic level with palm pulses. If you can do the palm pulses in push-up position easily, then it's time to practice the false grip on the bar. I highly recommend to use chalk for this one because with slippery hands, it's basically impossible to hold the false grip. Bend your wrists like if you want to form an anchor and hang yourself on the bar, same as in the rings muscle up. The only difference here that the bar will not lay in your hands as on the rings, so it will be more difficult. Even if it's not the most comfortable, fold your fingers and use your thumbs as well. This is really important. In the beginning, you can practice that with inverted rows or with leg assistance, so you don't need to use your whole body weight. Finally, it's worth to be able to hold it with full body weight in the passive hang. If you can do pull-ups with the false grip, you'll surely be on track. This one is the most difficult part of the slow motion bar muscle up. However, you can do the slow-mo muscle up using a normal grip, it's just much more difficult, and actually it's more beneficial to have a slippery bar or a spinning barbell that you can use in the gym. Because of the slow transition, your elbow and triceps will be under much more load compared to the regular execution. As I've showed in the elbow preparation video, some basic movements and reps are always useful before workout. In the joint preparation program, you can strengthen your elbows on a basic level, and specifically for the slow motion muscle up, you can do Russian push-ups and dips to the forearms to bulletproof your elbows further. These exercises can even be the beginner progressions of the muscle up since they help to improve the right technique. I highly recommend to incorporate them to your workouts if your goal is the slow motion muscle up. You may think it's obvious, but it's worth to mention. You'll only be able to do the slow motion muscle up if you can do full range of motion pull-ups and dips. I think it's important to highlight, as I've mentioned in my previous videos, most people who learn the muscle up are not able to do full range of motion pull-ups and dips because they do the muscle up with kipping. If you do that, your muscle up doesn't include the right pulling and pushing as it's supposed to. I've already talked about it earlier. The point is that in the slow motion muscle up, you can't avoid the full range of motion pull-up and dip. If you'll face this issue when you start to practice, it's gonna be a humiliating moment, but believe me, it's worth to go back to the basics. You won't regret the full range of motion pull-up and dip. You can find my videos about how to do regular pull-ups, dips, even straight bar dips on the channel. The point of the slow motion muscle up is the same as in the regular one. The forward lean after the pull up is the most important part of the technique. Since there is no generated momentum, this one is gonna be a little bit tough. That's why I mentioned the Russian push ups and forearm dips. Those will help a lot, even as first progressions. What I also would like to highlight is the regular rings muscle up technique because it's really similar and helps a lot to improve this one. So these will be the prerequisites. I apologize to referring so many times to the previous videos, but they are really important and it would be too long and also unnecessary to repeat them in one video here. That's why I always emphasize that you need a system where the small parts add up and help you to improve maximally. If you're interested in my system, click the link below and get started today. And now, let's see some really effective progressions that will help you to improve the slow motion bar muscle up. As a first step, you can do leg assisted reps on a lower bar. Like this, all movements will be less intensive. The false grip, the pulling, and the transition. Okay, you can do a full dip, but you don't have to if you don't want to. If you have the basics, you can save your strength there. Do 2 to 4 sets of 3 to 5 reps of these, and if you can do them with confidence, move forward. The eccentric slow motion muscle up is one of the best progressions in my opinion. I'm sure you've heard about the eccentric method, which means that if you can't do the concentric phase of an exercise, you can build strength with the negative phase really efficiently. That's particularly true for the slow motion muscle up. Here, you need to start from the upper endpoint, from the straight arm support, descending slowly and controlled with getting into the false grip. In the beginning, you can do it on a lower bar, slightly assisting with your legs. Put some chalk on your hands, especially to your wrists, so you won't slip out from the false grip. Get into the straight arm support, then start to descend slowly to the lower endpoint of the dip. From here, lean back with control and twist your hands into false grip. Keep your upper body as close to the bar as possible. The best if you can touch the bar with your chest all the time. Keep your elbows right next to your body. From the upper endpoint of the pull-up, descend to passive hang with holding the false grip. This is really important. Do 2 to 3 sets of 1 to 3 reps. In the next step, you should be able to do the concentric phase with a resistance band. Choose the right intensity band for you that you can always change as you progress. Put some chalk on your hands, especially to your wrists, so you won't slip out from the false grip. Stand in the resistance band with both of your legs, then grab the bar in false grip. From here, pull up yourself controlled in full range of motion, same as in the regular pull-up, minimum until your chest height. There, lean forward, pull yourself strongly, and when your forearms reach the horizontal, switch to strong pushing while you lean forward continuously. Here, it's totally normal if you flex your hip. This is how you can lean forward more easily. With the strong pulling, pushing, and forward lean, you'll get into the support where you just need to push up yourself to the straight arm support. This process will be a lot easier with the right elastic band, so you can get stronger gradually. Do single reps in 5 sets. To ensure the right technique for a slow motion muscle up, you can practice only the transition part. After all the previous progressions, you can practice this with an elastic band as well, then without it. It's worth to start the exercise in support, descend to the lower endpoint of the dip, and from there, lean back with control, keeping your elbows next to your body to the upper endpoint of the pull-up, and from there, with a strong pull and push, get back to the bent arm support. As I've mentioned in one of my previous videos, this movement is much harder because of the longer leverage, which is the length of your forearm. This is a difficult but manageable movement, that's why I recommend to do it with the elastic band first. One more advice for the easier execution. After you descend it to the bent arm hanging, your legs will swing a little bit. Start the pull back when your legs are moving backward. That will help the movement a lot, same as the hip flexion and ab contraction during the transition. In this movement, I guarantee you'll feel the benefits of the Russian push-ups and dips. Do 2-4 sets and 1-3 reps, and if you got this, you're ready for the full slow motion muscle up. And we arrived at the real slow motion muscle up, where you need to do the following. Put some chalk on your hands, especially to the wrist line, and grab the bar with false grip. From here, pull up yourself controlled in full range of motion, same as in the regular pull up, minimum until your chest height, then lean forward, pull yourself strongly, and when your forearms reach the horizontal, switch to strong pushing while you lean forward continuously. Here it's totally normal if you flex your hip. This is how you can lean forward more easily. With the strong pulling, pushing, and forward lean, you'll get into the support where you just need to push up yourself to the straight arm support. The best if you inhale before you start the movement and maintain the pressure in your stomach, then exhale slowly when you get through the transition. How many reps should you do? The most common is one single rep. This is kind of a show-off exercise, but of course you can do sets of 2-3 reps if you want to. Personally, sometimes I do a rep in a few sets in my vertical push-pull workout. It definitely feels different and gives you a different load than the regular muscle-up, so I highly recommend for you to master it as well. What I can personally say about this exercise, that it's not easy. The most difficult parts are the false grip and the transition for sure. But if you have the right basics, you've done a general joint preparation program, basic strength program, you've learned the muscle-up on the rings, and you are familiar with some weighted reps, you'll be alright. This exercise will be also the result of the basics, so don't forget, the most important thing you need is a good system and consistency. If you're interested in the exact same system that I use, click the link below, join now on gymnasticsmethod.com, where you can find all my programs, tutorials, series, daily workouts and much more. I can also help you personally in the private group on the live Q&A sessions, so do not hesitate to get started now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did so, please like, share, and write a comment what do you want to see in the next videos. If you don't want to miss the new videos, subscribe with notifications on, and see you next week in the next video.